Today's topic is double reinforced concrete, regular beam naman ano. Ito yung difference naman sa kabilang nagawa kong video just before this ano. That is only regular beam, meaning walang notches to sa ating compression concrete, no? To sa side na may compression. So what will be the effect ano? We will find out later. So let's proceed no. So be ready to be neuralized. Suppose that you have this beam, a concrete cover of 50 mm for the tension side, and actually it is 60 mm naman for the compression side. However, there is a notch, no? As it looks like, it is a trapezoidal notch with the given and specified dimensions. So, given that the Fc prime is 21 megapascal and Fy, 415 megapascal. So, we are to find the following. Given that the beam is non-ductile, meaning we are to assign the maximum ductility requirement as per non-ductility condition or non-ductile condition. So, determine the height of the compression block, which is letter A in our nomenclature in the calculation. As presented before in the conceptualization of the doubly reinforced concrete beam as well as the singly reinforced concrete beam. So letter B is to find the ultimate moment capacity and then followed by the area of the effective concrete for compression and finally the maximum steel ratio. These ABCD questions, ano dapat, ano to, ano, pertinent ito kung ano yung true condition ng beam, lalo na yung maximum steel ratio. Kailangan depende siya kung ano yung true nature ng beam. Kung, kasi may maximum steel ratio for the singly, meron din maximum steel ratio para sa doubly. So, let's proceed. Okay. So, this time, we have to break down the parts of the beam. No? If you will notice, I've just drawn the concrete itself. No? Assuming that you have viewed my video tutorial and discussion to on those two videos prior to this one, whereas I have discussed a principle as per computation is concerned and as well as a sample problem for a rectangular beam showing and showcasing all the diagrams no up to the strain. Now you will notice that the formulas as presented before are just only redundant considering the area of the or area of the effective concrete just dependent on the compression concrete that is present. So therefore, let me proceed with this one. So, therefore, may mga new parts tayo. Assuming, syempre, hindi pa natin sigurado kung singular doubly, but we need to identify the parts. Note that we have, so, it is easy to identify again that the 520 pieces, 5 pieces of 20 mm diameter is a tension, no, tension bar, while 216 mm is the compression. Why? Because of the area. No, mas maliit, ano, ang compression bar kumpara sa tension bar dapat. No, that's the nature. So, therefore, 520 pieces of tension. Okay. Notice that D is equal to D sub T, or yung effective depth is equal to the effective depth that is found on the maximum tensile strain. Why is it so? We are only having one layer of reinforcement. Okay? Then, followed by, don't forget that there is a notch. No? Ang ginawa kong partition dito, pwede naman kasing isang rectangle. Parang ito yung mangyayari. So, one rectangle. No? And one, say, triangle on the shaded area. Pwede naman ganyan. Ngayon, in my calculation, I will proceed with two triangles. No? Para for me, at tinahita ko mas mabilis. No? May nakikita kang in violet as parang ano siya, no? Isosceles. Ayan. In violet. I'll shade a little, and also in green, yung right triangle, ayan. So, yan yung na-visualize natin dyan. So, yan yung cut portion na i-analyze natin, okay? So, I completed the details. So, we have to calculate, okay, the steel area. No, 5 piraso di 20, we will arrive to 500 pi mm squared. Also, AS prime, 2 pieces of 16 mm, so 128 pi. And then D is equal to D sub T, that is 140 mm. So why did I get that? So 400 is the sum of D or D or DT plus this distance. No, that this is composed of 50 mm plus half of the bar diameter as being noted here, no? Kasi diameter yan, so tatama sa kalahati. So, sa mismong diameter. So, meaning, so we need to deduct the half of the diameter size 20. So, we will arrive to 340. Might as well consider the D prime. Baka biglang gamitin natin mamaya. At least naka-ready, naka-standby. So, meaning, nasa center ka ng rebar group. So, up to the last layer dapat, no? Ng compression fiber concrete. No? Yung extreme fiber. So, ito yung D prime. So, you have to add half of the bar diameter 16 plus 40 and then plus 20. So, parang ladder type yung pagkaka-add sa kanya. Okay? Also, don't forget that beta 1 is 0.85y because the FC prime that was given in the problem is less than 28. We are going to deal with 21 MPa. So, okay? Now, where do we start? Ngayon, we need to identify if this is singly or doubly. Tandaan nyo, kapag ka singly, may sarili siyang Romax. At kapag doubly, may sarili siyang Romax. So, fail-safe to start with a singly reinforced concrete beam. So, kapag na-compute nyo yung Romax at mas tumaas pa rin yung rho, therefore, it is doubly. So, beyond the control of the doubly. Okay? So, setting Fs is equal to Fy, then we should analyze it by using the balance condition. Kasi bakit balance? Binigay kasi kanina yung condition ng non-ductile condition. Kung marerecall nyo, kapag non-ductile, ang ating rho max is 0.75 no? Of rho balance. So, yung sinabi ko na on the video that I discussed using the in the principle of computing the ductility requirements. No? Depende. So, therefore, I should consider balance condition. After that, I will convert balance rho balance or the steel ratio at balance condition into the maximum steel ratio. So, that's the idea. Kapag nagsimula ka na ng ductile or ductile, okay? So therefore, na-derive na natin to before kasi itong formula to gamit ito sa strain. So therefore, hindi siya dependent kung may notch or walang notch yung ating concrete beam. So therefore, it is generic to apply kahit irregular shape yung ating concrete beam. So ma-identify pa natin yung proper location in the balance condition kung saan magkakaroon ng balance yielding yung concrete, compression tsaka steel yielding, no? Tension, I mean. Pero hindi pa tayo sigurado kung yung compression bar mo ay magi-yield. So let us find out. So, you find out that the value is 170.874 sa A-balance. Computing that the C-balance is 600D over 600 plus Fy as already derived before, we will have 200.985 to 52 mm. And then, don't forget that A-balance is beta 1 C-balance, whereas the beta 1 is 0.85, no? Already iterated earlier. So, considering sigma C balance or the force of compression under balance is equal to the summation of all tension force at balance condition, then we will have this. No? Medyo self-explanatory na ito. No? Derived na natin before by using an illustration using the flexural behavior. So, that is the volume of the compression block. So, ngayon, ano yung AC balance? So, don't forget that whenever we take a look, no, let's say you have this in the figure A. Ang gawin mo lang, let's set A be equal to A balance lang naman, no? So, therefore, set A is equal to A balance. So, diyan ka nalang titingin para at least, ang figure mo is just 1, no? Para at least di ka na nalilito. Okay? So, therefore, what you need to understand is that the neutral axis coordinate, it is the height of the compression block. So, ito, yan, yung aking shadan. That is the area that we need to check and understand paano siya magbibigay ng area of the effective concrete under balance condition. Kaya ito si shade natin. Yan lang ang ating titingnan. Okay? So, by that, mapapansin nyo, yung area of resemblance niya will be, parang what if binuukulan lang siyang rectangle, no? Tuloy-tuloyin ko to, tapos ibawas natin yung mga uka na to. Yan, yung si shade natin. Yan. Okay? So, yan yung AC balance. Kaya that's why you have noticed that in this figure, I will compute AC balance in this way. No? 300 A balance as buo minus kanya-kanyang triangle. So, 1 half base height lang naman ang principle dyan ng geometry. So, if you will take a look on this isosceles, yan, I will shade in violet, let's say, or yan, yung shaded triangle. So, yan yung 1 half upon 75 by 20. Ito yun. Na ibabawas natin, syempre. Tapos, yung isa pa, in mark in color green. Wag naman green, ano. May same color na pala niyan. So, let's say in blue. O yan. Ito, yan. Yung triangle na isa. Okay? So, ito naman siya. Bakit deductible? Eh, mapabawas yung area natin. Kung ang property ng area is to be added, then you should add. Pagka deductible, then you should deduct. No, yan yung principle ng Varignon, no? So, therefore, we will come up with a simplified solution of 300A balance minus 3,000. Actually, yan na rin yung ano, area of the effective concrete equation. Tanggalin mo yung balance, ibalik mo siya sa A. So, meaning, mamaya, pag nag-compute tayo, pati yung AC natin is just only equal na rin sa 300A minus 3,000. Yung 3,000 na constant na direct sa pinagsamang mga full value. Yan, nung mga uka. Okay? Para mamaya meron tayong reference value. Okay, and then we will find out that Robal, of course, ASBAL is Robal BD, no, already discussed before. And then we continue to the identification of Robalas at singly reinforced 0.02035. But don't forget that we have non-ductile condition taken as K of 0.75. So you will get 0.01526, no, as I interpret ano, at least 5 significant digit ang max ang ductility requirement. And then the actual rho o yung seal ratio rho is that is AS. Don't forget that we have calculated AS 500 pi. And then BD. So we have calculated the effective depth D that is yielding to an amount of 340. Then we found out that the actual seal ratio is 0.0154. Then we compare. Now if this is true, through singly reinforced concrete beam, then we should find out that rho should be less than rho max if that is the case. However, that rho is more than rho max. So it is not singly. Rather, it is doubly reinforced concrete beam. Now therefore, the true rho maximum will adjust. Lalaki pa. But to fit the idea that rho max should be always more than rho, dependent on what assumption you are considering, kung singly ba or doubly. Either of the case, dapat walang rho maximum na mas mababa sa rho. Otherwise, you're doing it wrong. Kasi it displays the property of the material. Okay? Now, here it goes, ano? Considering that the beam is now a doubly, then we start the assumption. Before, I discussed already the shifting theorem ng ating neutral axis kung nagsimula ka lang kung both bars are yielding. And I already stated that you can start anyway, ano, and in any assumption that you can do, meaning you can set no both bars are not yielding, or you can set tension bar does not yield and compression bar does yield, no? However, what is the more realistic approach to make the compression concrete to be relaxed? We should make hanggat maaari. But don't note, no, this is investigation. That may happen. No? Most of the time, it happens. But in the field of investigation, if you're not designing, then the reinforcement already given, then there can be some cases that bars on compression may yield. No, but that is not the ideal case. That is dangerous. Okay, just for a reflection of reality. Now, you notice that I started with an assumption with that Fs as it is more than Fi, meaning I want to set that the tension steel will be more than Fy. So, if that is the case, then no stress should be more than the yielding stress. So, automatic, when you have an Fs that is more than Fy, then use Fs equal to Fy. Pero, if I will use Fs prime that is less than Fy, then I should consider that the formulation for Fs prime is not already equal to Fy since I am accepting that it is less than. So, already derived before using the strain diagram, so Fs prime is equal to 600 over C quantity C minus D prime. Pero ano ulit yung D prime natin? Don't forget that it is 68 mm in our calculation. That's why I supply it already. I hope you understand that, ano, doon sa ating dinerive before. Full, ano yun, talagang pinakita ko lahat yung derivation doon. Okay? And don't forget that we have a third assumption why this exists. Kasi yung A natin, dapat lumagpas siya sa compression bar. No? Note that this is the layer of the compression bar. Para maging compression bar yan, dapat ang inyong value of A, height of compression block, lumagpas siya. Otherwise, kapag nandito, mark, let's say, in color blue, no, let me put into a highlight, kasi nandito siya nag-exist, no? Yan yung compression block height mo, yung shaded region na yan, mukhang imposible yata. Sabi sabihin, ito, tsaka yan, na dalawang compression na 16, hindi siya compression, tension yan. Para nangyari, ito, tsaka yung 520 pieces ay naging multi-layer reinforcement na may rebar center ka dito. So, magbabago yung effective depth D mo. Dito na siya magko-concentrate. No? Yung bagong D, which is not ideal. Para nangyari, sobrang laki ng dimension ng concrete beam mo. So, that's a problem of most, no, pag na nagde-design. No? Masyadong na-exaggerate. So, be careful. So, kaya, that's why there's some origin of why I am arriving to a dimension like 250 by 400, 350 by 450, or 300 by 450, or 400. Because of that. Okay? So, I need to check these three assumptions. I need to make sure that all of those assumptions are validated. Otherwise, I will correct my assumption on the next discussion of this computation, I mean. Okay? Now, we proceed. Now, sigma C is equal to sigma T. Note that A is equal to beta 1 C. But note that beta 1 is 0.85. No? I already explained why. So, again, dahil hindi ko pinag-yield yung bakal ko sa compression, hindi ko siya i-treat as Fy, as Fs prime. At gagamitin ko ito. Doon ko siya isasalpak. Pero, dahil in-assume ko na Fs mo ay nag-yield sa tension, so therefore, isasalpak ko siya as Fy. Okay, be careful, no? Dapat, ano, nagre-reflect, no, kung ano in-assume mo, tsaka sa kinakalculate. Don't forget that in the AC, we have 300A kanina, minus 3,000, pero A is beta 1C. Kaya ito, 300 times 0.85 of C, kasi yung 0.85 of C, ito yung A sana. Okay? So, therefore, computing that, so, we'll get 131.0538, and A as 111.3958. Note, taken from, note that C is equal to A over beta 1, kasi A is equal to beta 1C. Kaya nakakuha ka ng 111 dyan. Tanong, did I satisfy one of my assumption? Let us verify. Is that more than 76? Yes. Obviously. So, therefore, that so far, we have a good assumption. Okay? So the third assumption is satisfied. Let us put a check mark. Then, ano titira na yung dalawa? By using the strain diagram before, already the derived equations, I hope that it is instills, no, to your mind, paulit-ulit kasi itong formula na yan. So therefore, we found out that Fs by calculation using the C and the D that's been pre-calculated, so 956.6123, that is, of course, obviously more than Fy. Then, we accept that Fs equal to Fy. So far, that is okay because it satisfy more than Fy. So okay, check po tayo sa isang condition. Also, the Fs prime, as we have calculated, 600 over C, quantity C minus 68, we have 288.6775 megapascal. So, it looks like it is more less than Fy. So, we trace that Fs prime is less than Fy. So, this is also okay because that is our second set of assumption. That's why we use this main formula as we derive from the strain diagram to denote that we are accepting that the bars or compression won't yield. So, if all of the assumptions are being validated, walang iniwanang mali, then we said that this is the true condition of the beam. So, kahit hindi ka na magtry ng error, it is safe naman, no, to start with this also. I suggest that make your compression bar to not yield because of the basic reasoning to make the concrete compression to be relaxed before it yields. Kasi yan ang primary, ano? Kapag naunan mag-yield yung compression bar, damay na si compression concrete. So, therefore, concrete fails sometimes. Delikado, lalo na kung cracking will follow on compression. The crack should be start with tension. Mas maganda sana ganun. Okay? So, we accept that the height of compression block is 111.1358. So, that is the answer for letter A kanina. No, A as the height of compression block. Dahil na-prove natin na ito ay lahat ay nagtali. Otherwise, kakalculate tayo. Parang ginawa natin sa past video, doon sa may regular beam na may multiple layered. So, di ba nag-assume ako na may maling condition? Then, I correct the idea. But I didn't accepted the values kapag nasa maling validation. Okay, or hindi nag-satisfy kahit isa lang sa mga assumption. Okay, so therefore, we can now compute the maximum tensile strain. So note that d is equal to dt kasi nga singular po yung ating reinforcement to recall. And we will identify that the strain maximum, or the maximum tensile strain found on the beam is 0.00478 or on the tension concrete produced by the steel tension nearest to the tension fiber of concrete is less than 0.005 and above 0.002. Already discussed before that when this happens, you are under transition zones. Tatlo po yan. May compression control kapag less than 0.002, no? Kapag may more than 0.005, as we have already discussed last video, it is transition tension control limit. While if you're in between these two, that is transition zone. May pang-compute tayo ng reduction factor phi. I already derived this to you, ano? Yung the first way is using the maximum strain compatibility, and also the other one, what if I introduce the ratio between the effective depth under maximum tensile strain, and might as well consider yung relation niya sa neutral axis height. So, either of the two, when you use the d sub t as d, ayan, no? You can supply, no? This data. May data ka dito. Oops. It's not the one that I should encircle. Ito, no? May d sub t ka, no? Na-compute na. E sub t, ito siya. So, also see, no? I-calculated kanina. Just before the solution. So, therefore, you can arrive to a similar value of 0.8819. So, this means that this is the reduction factor for flexure. Tandaan nyo na maraming form of reduction factor. Meron sa shear, meron sa bearing, meron sa column as compression controlled. Marami. Pati sa torsion, no? Marami yan. So, flexure muna. Okay. So, why there is a need for me to understand this triangle of this section? Now, notice that I have calculated the true value of A. So I might want to consider and focus on this area. Ang tanong, if you recall the nominal moment of the first stage, we have said that it is 0.85 fc prime a sub c times d minus bar sub z. Kailan nagiging a over 2 ang bar sub z? Kapag walang uka. Eh may uka ka nga. So therefore, dito magre-resemble yung bar sub z kasi yun yung gagamitin natin sa moment arm para ma-compute ang nominal moment under the first stage, or you can call it the nominal moment under the single reinforced concrete beam stage. Okay? So, therefore, using Varignon, kasi yung center na yan, ang location ng Z, which is this one, dyan naka-concentrate yung C sub 1. So, we need to understand that condition by calculating this very meaningful value bar sub Z. Okay? So, therefore, using Varignon, then we found out that the area of the effective concrete using the A that we have calculated as a true condition, that 111 point something we have calculated earlier. So, we found out that it is area of effective concrete, 30,418.7261 square millimeter. Now, using that, then using Varignon, what I want to do is this, no? I want to set all of my new centroid location, no? I mean, the axis that I might want to put toward all of the centroids is going to the bar section, to the top section Y, para makukuha ka agad yung bar sub Z. Kaya kung gusto mo, ito kunin mo. Let's say, you want a letter, let's say bar Y. Then, tandaan nyo, kung may T ka dito, alam nyo yung moment arm dito. Okay? So, alam nyo natin na ito yung effective depth D. So, might as well consider again this bar sub Z by computing A minus bar Y, and then suddenly this becomes D minus bar sub Z din. So, might as well, consider mo na kaya yung bar sub Z na lang agad, no? Para hindi ka na magtatranslate nung ating mga significant values. Anyway, hindi mo na kailangan mo at the end yung bar sub Z agad. So, therefore, we continue. No, I want the location or the point of the moment I'm toward to be towards the top section of the concrete beam under compression. So, therefore, you will going to have this. So, all the centroids will be projected towards. Kaya ito, rectangular, A over 2. Meron kang isosceles. This is 1/3. And this one is 2/3. Ayan, no? Ito may 1/3, no? 20 over 3 para sa isosceles. Ayan. Ito naman yung para sa right triangle. Main objective, pataasin nyo yung centroid. So, therefore, by that, ano, may makakukuha tayong value to be used, no, in the identification of the nominal moments. So we can compute that bar sub z is 60.2596 as shown on this portion. Ayan, andyan siya, no, lumabas na. Therefore, using that, we can now calculate the first stage. Note that c was equal to t1. I think you recall this, and then 0.85 FC prime multiplied by the area of the effective concrete, which is, ito na siya, no, na-compute na natin, no? Meron tayo na-compute kanina regarding this statement. Oh, this one will reflect on that. It's not that. It is AS1 that I have encircled. So, this one to be reflecting that one. Okay? So, therefore, we can get AS1 is 1,308.3717 mm². And then don't forget that we can transcribe to the formulas of the nominal moment, no? As we set C or T as the moment arm, then I think you already know by this far, no? The first form is this one, and the second form is the other one. Ito yung resemblance ng C1 times D minus bar sub Z, at saka ito naman si T sub 1 na may multiplication sa 2D minus bar sub Z. Okay? So, kahit anong gamitin nyo doon, is isa yung lalabas, no? Nominal moment of first stage is 151.8919 kN. Okay, now, itabi muna natin si phi para maalala. Okay, now consider the second stage. Kung naalala niyo yung computation na yan, so therefore, AS prime quantity FS prime minus 0.85 FC prime equals AS to FY. Tandaan nyo kanina, no? If you were to recall that FS prime is less than FY, so I cannot set that FS prime is to be equal to FY. So therefore, I should use the calculated FS prime. So if you recall, you can check my calculation earlier. So what I get is 288.6775 MPa for the FS prime, ano, under normal condition. So therefore, you will get AS2 as 262.4246. Then to be followed by checking. Siyempre, tingnan natin kung tama. Ganun ulit yung principle. AS1 plus AS2 is equal to AS. Ano yung AS ulit? That is 500 pi. AS1, na-compute natin kanya, is 1,308.3717. And the same around, no, AS is 262.4246. O, pag-convert mo 500 pi at pinag-add mo AS1 AS2, it seems they are equal. So, therefore, we are on the right track. To continue, no, MN2, already described before in the principle discussion. So, therefore, we already understand right now that this is the CS prime multiplied by the moment arm D minus C prime. D minus D prime, whereas our D prime is pre-calculated as 68. Kanina, na-compute na yan. Also, AS2 times FY, kasi nag-ildaman yung bakas sa tension, but not in the compression. Okay? So, therefore, we can now calculate by substituting all important values, then you will arrive 29.6025. Now, please do the job for me in replacing all the values. Makukompute nyo rin naman. Then we follow on MS equal to the sum of all nominal moments. So we have two stages. Then we come up with 181.5144. But does it suggest? It does not suggest that the nominal moment is the capacity. What we are looking for under USD, it is the with respect to the factor of safety. So that is the introduction of phi with respect to the flexure, which is 0.8819, no, na-calculate natin. So 1 over this one is a factor of safety against flexure. No? Kailan lang yung simple niyan. So, therefore, the capacity of the section for not to fail is 160.0775 kN. So, that is the capacity of the section. It's the answer to the problem. Now, to continue, it is being asked, ano yung maximum ductility requirement? So, therefore, we need to find out that, again, balikan nyo lang kanina computation, ano? Kasi, di ba, may CBAL tayo na na-compute? Yung CBAL equals 600D, no? Over FY plus 600. I hope recall that. So, ginamit ko lang yung value niya kanina na na-compute natin is 170.8074. Yung pinakauna in identifying the ductility requirement even it is singly reinforced concrete beam. Then, I want to do a checking kung ano ba ang naging case ng FS prime underbalance. Now, supplying all the values. Tandaan nyo lang kung ano yung naging CBAL kanina in the one of the sessions, one of the slides presented. Pag sinalpak nyo, sumasakto siya 397 MPa. Okay? Observably less than FY yan. No? So, what does it mean? So, therefore, FS prime is equal to 27, no? Hindi siya lumupo sa Fy. So, the compression bar does not yield. So, ibig sabihin, relax yung compression bar natin kahit nag-yield na yung tension. Question, is it good? Yes. Kailangan natin lang relax sa compression bar kahit nag-yield na yung tension tsaka compression concrete. Hayaan nyo mag-interrelate yun. Huwag na lang natin dagdagan ng ano, ang burden ng concrete compression. Ganun ang action ni compression bar talaga eh. Hanggat mare. It should act whenever it is needed. Otherwise, it can put burden to the compression concrete. Okay, that's the ideal case. Hanggat mare, it is not yielding kapag compression bar. Therefore, using sigma C-bar equal to sigma T-bar, replacing all important element. So, ayan, no, sigma, raw ball naman siya ulit in the form. But this is the raw balance, different to the first one. This should be higher than the previous one. Kasi raw ball kanina, that is under singly. And we are aware that the doubly reinforced concrete beam is above being singly. So, therefore, we expect also higher value of the raw balance. So, this will be a new value. So, therefore, we get 0.02395. Then, we proceed with the 0.74 raw balance. Bakit kanyo? Don't forget that we are under non-ductile. So, kapag ductile, that is 0.5. Pag non-ductile, 0.75. Then, we get this raw max, 0.01796. Ngayon, is it okay to have this value? Yes, the raw kanina na nakuha natin is less than this, ano? 0.014 or 0.015 lang siya. So, tama nga sinasabi natin kanina na mag-increase talaga yung raw max kapag ka-doubly kasi nga, may dumagdag kang bakal. So, what is the participating factor? Ito, oh, AS prime quantity 397 minus 0.85 AC prime kasi nakita natin na ang FS prime natin ay hindi nag-yield. Okay? So, nag-i-increase talaga because of that. Okay? So, therefore, the answer for the maximum ratio or maximum seal ratio experienced by the concrete beam, which is in true condition na no, nag-doubly siya, hindi siya singly, is 0.01796. So, that is the bend, flexural behavior. Okay, that's end my video tutorial. So, don't forget to subscribe to my YT channel. Hit the like button and share. No, as found below. And then, thank you for watching. And then, before we end, thank you dun sa mga nagtsatsaga, no, na mag-view ng tutorial. I hope that they are learning. Even they are not Filipinos, or I rather consider Filipinos kasi talagang ang module of my language is Tagalog because I think the viewer of this video are aware that most of the educational related videos that are made on YouTube channels are most likely Indians and British or people from Greek, from Europe. So medyo nahirapan tayo. So I hope that you support no yung gawang Pilipino. So, for me to strive more, then please help me by subscribing to my channel and then like and share, no? But before we end, let me say this to you. Salamat, and you have been neurorized. Please stay tuned for our next tutorial.